Hey everyone, welcome to Volleyball Pro Mindset, where we analyze professional volleyball players and games and learn how to apply their techniques, work ethic, and mindset to our own lives. My name is Coach Donnie, and I study, coach, train, and play volleyball for a living, and I'm obsessed with volleyball. In this video series, we are studying what makes certain pro players so good. Make sure you watch my last video about Saeed Marouf, who is one of the most deceptive and accurate setters in the world. For this video, we'll be studying one of the most exciting opposite hitters to watch from Japan, Yuji Nishida. He is only 6'1", or 185.5 centimeters, and weighs 192 pounds, or 87 kilograms, and is only 22 years old. He is currently playing professionally in Italy, which is one of the best volleyball leagues in the world. Here are five things that make Yuji Nishida so good. The first one is that he is physically very strong and well-conditioned. You can see videos of him lifting weights year-round and taking his off-the-court training very seriously. He doesn't just go through the motions for exercise like many other professional players do. He's lifting heavy and working out his full body. He also has a slightly thicker build compared to the typical volleyball player, indicating that he has more muscle than the average pro volleyball player. This is something he definitely put a lot of work into over a short period of time because he was much skinnier just a few years ago. So how does strength benefit volleyball? You see here how he doesn't even need an approach to still jump very high and spike powerfully. He can still execute even with a short approach as well. For most athletes, majority of their vertical jump and spiking power comes from the speed of their spiking approach, which is how it should be. But when you take away their hitting approach, they become very weak, but not Yuji Nishida. Strength is a critical component for increasing your power and speed, as well as injury prevention. If you want to increase your own vertical jump and jump like Yuji Nishida, check out my jump training programs linked in the description box below. The second reason is he has a very aggressive penultimate step, which means his second to last step is nearly twice the length of the previous step. And if you want to learn anything about maximizing your vertical jump, it's all about pushing as much power as you can through your penultimate stride, which is responsible for majority of the power in your vertical jump. You can see how he intentionally pushes into his penultimate step every time he jumps to hit the ball. The third reason is he has a very aggressive backswing during his penultimate step, which means he swings his arms all the way back and up near or above shoulder height with straight elbows and arms. This allows him to generate the maximum momentum into his vertical jump, which also carries into his arm swing. Many hitters make the mistake of having a shorter backswing by either swinging them below shoulder height or keeping their elbows bent. This shorter style backswing does create a faster approach, but you sacrifice a lot of vertical jump and spiking power. When you're a 6'1" opposite hitter, you don't have that luxury and you need to max jump every single time you spike. The fourth reason is that he stays open to the setter when he's hitting from the right side. This allows him to generate a lot of torque when he rotates through the ball. Torque is the rotational force created by the rotation of the hips, torso, and shoulders. This type of torque is very similar to the power generator from throwing a ball or swinging a bat. This also allows him to put his entire body weight into the ball. The fifth reason is that he maintains a mostly upright torso as he's spiking, which allows him to keep the ball in front of his hitting shoulder and easily change the direction of his spike, whether it's sharp angle, seam, or line. This also allows him to jump straight up when he's spiking in the front row and maintain balance and control in the air as he's broad jumping from the back row. Now we're going to do some more analysis of Yuji Nishida here. So Yuji Nishida does a 3- and 4-step approach. I think here he does a 3-step approach. So he goes right, left, right. And we're going to emphasize some of the errors that we talked about. So here he pushes off powerfully off of his right foot into that big stride. So see how long his penultimate step is and how his backswing is really big, so his arms are at peak height behind him the moment his penultimate step hits the floor. And as he transitions, he has a nice wide base, and see how he's upright even as he's spiking. That allows him to stay in control of his body. A lot of hitters make the mistake of leaning one side or the other excessively, and that throws off your balance, and you just can't rotate as effectively when you're leaning one side. So he's able to change direction pretty easily there. And I love his celebrations. He looks like he just assassinated someone every time he gets a kill. Now from the back row attack, and a really great seam kill. Wow, he starts his approach all the way from the baseline. So now he's doing a four-step approach, which helps him get a little bit more momentum for an even bigger jump. And that's the nice thing about being an opposite hitter, is you don't have to worry about passing and receive. You just transition and just focus on hitting left, right, left, right. So he does that four-step approach here. Now notice that each step, his steps gradually get bigger. So it's small, a little bit bigger, really big, back to medium. And when he's jumping, see how his feet are wider than his shoulder width. That helps transition his hips, because it takes time for your momentum to transfer from horizontal to vertical momentum. Even though he's jumping from the back row, you see how he's still upright. And look how open he is to the setter. You can see the number on the back of his jersey. Now, if you're left-handed and you're hitting from the right side, you want to open up, because it's natural for you to rotate from left to right. So he's open and he rotates his hips, torso, and shoulders, and still upright there. And you can tell because he's landing with control into that seam. See how he's open, whole chest is facing the setter, and he contacts it perfectly over his left shoulder, and he finishes. Now this is another thing we could talk about. This is a great angle too. This is a pretty decent seam here, and Yuji Nishida also has very good vision when he hits. You see how he's following through where he wants the ball to go. So you see how he's pointing. Look at his fingers, they're still pointing in that direction. So wherever you point and follow through, that's where the ball is gonna go. So contacting over his left shoulder, following through toward the center of his body in order to hit the ball in the seam between two blockers. Now I think this one Yuji Nishida is going to hit down the line, which is one of the hardest things to do from the back row, because you know, you're jumping 3 meters behind the line. And this is a great view of how he's going. Now we'll talk about his arm motions. So he does more of a jogging approach, which is more common on a four step. So he's jogging. See how when he's taking his first step with his left, he's alternating his arms like he's jogging. Then he brings both arms up on the second step, and then on the third step, arms all the way back. Now, even though he's hitting the line, he opens up toward the setter, because it's very important as hitters to always face the same direction and open up towards the same direction every time, so the blockers don't know where you're going to hit. So from this position, he could still hit sharp angle, he could hit in the seam, he can hit down the line. And at the last second, he rotates just a little bit more. So still in front of his left shoulder. See how he's rotating all the way, so his chest is facing down the line. And more importantly, see where his hand's following through. It's pointing down the line in that direction. Very difficult to do from the back row. So this one was a good one to look at, where he's hitting in the angle out of system. Look at that adjustment there. So out of system means when the pass is not perfect, the set is usually going to be a little bit slower to give you more time to adjust to the imperfect situation. So a spike, a good cover by the libero, bump set from Ishikawa. And what's interesting is that Nishida is actually starting his approach a little bit more inside. And this is probably part of the Japanese system, where if it's a bump set, they probably want them to set it high, slightly inside, to kind of open up the court if it's going to be a high ball set. So he still does his four-step approach, left, right, left, right, but his timing is what's going to be really important. So when they're in system, he's leaving right before the setter touches the ball. But when you're out of system, you want to wait to see where the ball is first, so you see how Ishikawa's going to bump set it, and then Nishida starts his approach after the bump set. So it's a much higher set here. All the principles still stay the same. See how he's staying open to the court. Now this one's unique because he's hitting out of system into the angle. So he's still rotating a similar amount, except look at where his arm is following through. See how his arm is following through away from his body. So he's rotating still for power. And then he sees the triple block, and you see how much more court is open to the left side, contacting on the inside of the ball and following through to the left of his body. And look at where his arm is finishing, is to the side to get around the block. And he caught the right back from Poland, cheating a little bit. Okay, last thing we'll talk about is how relaxed Nishida's arm swing is. In the slow motion here, you see how he brings his arms up. So his right arm is up super high, and that's called your aiming arm or your balance arm. So when you're reaching high in the air, this allows your hitting arm to match the same height on contact. And see how his arm's super loose, really relaxed, his wrist is limp. That allows him to whip through the ball. And that's where you generate maximum power and speed, is having a very relaxed arm here. And it's so whippy that he's able to finish his arm swing well before he lands. So see how he's able to fall through all the way, almost at the peak of his jump, and then he's landing there. So if you want a fast arm swing, one way to trick your body into having a super fast arm swing is to try to finish your arm swing at the peak of your jump before you land. Look at that great follow through there. Good torque, rotational force. And actually, let's look at his serve here. So for a serve, he does a three-step approach. Right, left, right. Now the mechanics are identical. Big penultimate step, arms all the way back. This is the most important position when you're jumping. Still open, rotating for power. Great follow through. Now when you're jump serving, you have to be much more purposeful about pushing into this penultimate step here. So when you're pushing, see with his right leg, he's pushing forward, and that naturally lowers his hips into a squatted position. And then he gets upright by the time he contacts the floor with his right foot. Look how relaxed his arm is, really springy. Great contact over left shoulder and rotating. Look at that hip rotation. So hips are all the way open, almost 90 degrees. Rotating to the core, torso rotation, following through with his shoulders. So that's how he's able to generate a lot of power without much injury. He's putting his whole body weight into the ball there through the momentum of his approach, but more importantly, the rotation of his body. Now you've learned five things that makes Yuji Nishida so good and one of the best opposite hitters in the world. At only 6'1", let me know in the comments below why you think Yuji Nishida is so good. Make sure you subscribe to this channel so you never miss a video by clicking right here. And I know you're gonna love this video right here.